The three laws of robotics are often cited as one of the reasons why artificial intelligence will not take over humanity. But what are the three laws of robotics? Science fiction has always been interested in the ethics behind the advancement of technology, whether it was bringing the dead back to life, placing an entire society under surveillance, or AI taking over the universe to make more paperclips. The first half of the 20th century had several science fiction writers who were fascinated by robots. The most famous of them all was Isaac Asimov, who wrote I, Robot, a collection of short stories in which he invented the three laws of robotics.
The first law is as follows. A robot may not harm a human being or through inaction allow a human being to come to harm. Number two, a robot must obey orders given it by qualified personnel, unless those orders violate rule number one. Rule number three, a robot must protect its own existence. After all, it's an expensive piece of equipment.
Yeah, he says robot weird. That's a video for another time. In summary, a robot cannot harm a human being or ignore a human being in danger, and it must always obey an order from a human unless the order was to hurt a human or to ignore a hurt human, and it must always protect itself from getting destroyed unless it was ordered to self-destruct or its very existence is dangerous to humans. Simple. The real question is, do the three laws work? The whole point of iRobot is that the three laws don't work. The laws were purposefully written to only sound perfect while having a lot of issues within. Asimov was trying to write interesting sci-fi stories, not solve the entire field of AI ethics. These stories are interesting precisely because we get to see how these seemingly flawless laws are in fact extremely flawed. This is because the laws are interconnected, allowing them to interfere with each other, creating some pretty weird logical outcomes. Runaround, the second story in iRobot, is a clear example of this. It involves two humans and a robot who are trying to restart an abandoned mining station on Mercury, which requires selenium, which the humans order the robot to fetch. The robot doesn't return for several hours, forcing the humans to investigate what went wrong. They find the robot running in circles around the selenium pool, staggering side by side like it was drunk. As it so turns out, the robot was doing so because of a conflict between the second and third law. This robot was expensive and therefore had a slightly stronger third law, making it slightly more allergic to potential dangers. When the human gave the order, it followed the second law and went to fetch the selenium. There was some unknown danger in the selenium pool, which triggers the third law and makes it move away from the selenium pool. Once it got sufficiently far enough, the danger dissipates, and so the second law kicks back into action, making the robot move towards the selenium pool. Because the obey human law and the stay safe law keep interfering, the robot is stuck in an infinite loop of going back and forth and back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. Ultimately, this crisis is resolved by placing a human in danger in such a manner that only the robot could save his life. Happy ending, kinda. The human nearly lost his life because Mercury during the day is slightly warmer than what most humans are comfortable with. Another way these laws malfunction is because the words used, especially in the first law, are kind of vague. This is the premise behind Lyle, where a robot is found to have the ability to read minds and is being investigated by the company that created it. One of the investigators is the protagonist, Susan Calvin, who is in love with her co-worker. Reading her mind, the robot finds out that she is in love and tells her that the co-worker loves her back, which the robot would know because it could read his mind as well. Later, while talking to the co-worker, she finds out that he's getting married, except she is not the bride. The robot had lied? She figures out that the robot was simply following the first law. The robot knew that the co-worker was getting married but couldn't tell Callan because it would hurt her feelings. The first law prevents the robot from hurting a human being in any manner possible. And since this robot could read minds, it knows whether a human is hurting inside or not. It couldn't just tell her that he was getting married, that would be hurting her on purpose. It did the only logical thing it could do, it had to lie. So a robot following the first law should take care to not depress a human being? Apparently. If these logical problems at the human level aren't confusing enough, you also have to remember that these three laws have to be hard-coded into the robot's brain. How exactly are you going to teach a robot what or who counts as a human and what or who doesn't? What counts as hurting and what doesn't? Which orders to follow and which not to follow? And whether a robot should be aware of the fact that it is a robot at all? These questions are easy to ask, but impossible to find answers for and to teach a robot. So the next time you have an argument with your friend over whether or not AI will take over humanity and they strongly believe that the three laws will protect us, simply say no. send them this video to show they just might be wrong. While your idiot friend is doing that, why not press the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel? I hope you like this video and that idiot friend of yours who will continue being an idiot if they think that the three laws are perfect. Whatever. Thanks for watching!